On the service bench is a 1963 National Panasonic Transistor Radio. This is the model R-805, and it's a two-band AM shortwave unit. And I recently purchased this on eBay, and the seller claimed that it worked perfectly. So of course I figured, well, it's going to work. This will be great. I won't have to do anything to it. Well, needless to say, that wasn't the case, because here it is pulled apart on the bench because it didn't work perfectly. It had very weak audio output, and that's attributed usually to defective electrolytic capacitors. And as you can see, those are the light blue axial colored units. So there's four of them underneath the chassis. You can see there's a lot going on here. However, there is quite a bit more on the top of the board. It's a pretty dense PC board to begin with. But look, there's a couple underneath the AM ferret antenna. And there's three more underneath the AM ferret antenna. So that might need to come off so I can gain access to those. I got a couple right here which aren't too bad to get at. But then again, I might not even need to take that off. There's enough clearance there. I should be able to unsolder them from behind and pull those out with needle-nose pliers. You could see those caps all solder in right along that edge up here. Now if we look at the opposite side, right away, of course, the tuning string is in the way. The tuning string is always in the way. If you ever get to recap a radio and not have the tuning string in the way, you are a very, very fortunate person. So of course, this all has to be undone, because the second you touch that with your soldering iron, it's all over. That string will snap right in half. You can see it's a little involved. You got 3.5 turns on the tuning shaft. And it goes around the large pulley for the tuning condenser. And all the cords return and get tied onto the tension spring. So this is where it's advantageous to use your digital camera, take plenty of photos. But if you just insist solely on taking pictures, you really won't fully understand how the system works. That's why I always draw out a picture of how the system works, just a simple freehand sketch. So that way it kind of mentally programs it in my mind exactly how the system works. Because a lot of times you take something apart, not always do you get the photo of exactly what you're running into a problem with. So in this case, draw it out, take pictures. It's mentally locked in your mind. You shouldn't have any problems. So that's going to be a little involvement to get this thing recapped. There's a lot going on here. Here's a look at the case. Here's the little speaker. And you can see the leads I had to unsolder off the PC board, because I don't really want to deal with this thing in the way. It's kind of a nicely styled unit. It's got the tuner on the top. So I look forward to getting this one going again. It should probably have a really nice sound when it's all done. And I got my ESR meter. Not that that really does me much good, because I'm going to recap the entire thing anyway. But just for curiosity's sake, I checked the ESR on all the caps, and most of them are so bad that the ESR doesn't even register on the meter itself. So with some fresh new electrolytics, this thing should come back to life and play very well. Installation of the new capacitors are now complete. I installed all new Nichicon axial electrolytics where I could. These are my favorite caps next to the Sprague Adams. And a lot of wires here had to get moved out of the way to facilitate access to the solder terminals for the caps that protrude through the other side of the board. But I was able to maintain the original lead dress, so that worked out quite well. A couple more lytics here. And that cap on the bottom, that was kind of a tricky one to install. I had to pull the tuning hub off because the lead runs right underneath it. And there's also this Mitsubishi paper cap. I'm leaving that alone. In fact, that's still a good cap. All it does, it couples the auxiliary antenna input, which is just this Motorola connector here. But all in all, it worked out quite well. I did reuse the original insulation from the previous caps. And the tuning string, of course, was restrung, and I got it calibrated with the match mark on the left side of the tuning scale. We'll take a look at the top of the board. Here are the other new caps. You can see I had to install a radial cap here. It was originally an axial, but it was a very small value. It was a 0.47 microfarad at 15 volt. And the only available cap that Nichicon made was a 0.47 at 50 volt, but it came in a radial. That happened also with a 0.33 microfarad. Those are rather unusual sizes. I don't see those too much in the transistor radios. Usually caps are all above 1 microfarad. Here's a look at the other new ones. These ones here are the more typical values, 4.7 and 1 microfarad. But I did not have to remove the antenna bar. What I did to hold the caps in place seemed to work pretty well. I just took this piece of foam here and I just used my tweezers and I put it underneath and pressed it in, and it held the cap in place until I soldered it from the other side. So that worked out quite well. And here are the original caps. And here's an example of the new ones that were installed. This one here is just a 1 microfarad at 50. You could see it's considerably smaller. And this cap is 5 millimeter diameter by 12 millimeter long. And even though that's a 1 microfarad and I'm comparing it to a 100, this 1 microfarad is the exact size as the 100s, so the physical size of all the axials were all the same. And here's an example of the very, very small 0.47. See if my camera will focus on it. I guess not. But you can see it's very small. That's 4 millimeters in diameter, 7 millimeters high. So all I have to do now is solder back in the speaker and antenna terminals and reinstall it in the cabinet, and we should be good to go. One other thing I was curious about was the stamping here, 56330. And if you look this radio up in the SAMS index, it indicates it's a 1963 model, so I'm curious if that represents a date code of May 30th, 1963 for assembly. Suppose anything's possible. But I thought it'd be worth pointing that out. So it's all set and ready to be reinstalled. The radio is now fully reassembled and we're ready to try it out. Take a look at some of the exterior features. Here's the band switch. There's the auxiliary antenna connector. And this here is the tone control.
Pilgrims to 9/11. It's a pleasure to speak with him today. Welcome, William. Thanks so much for...
It's so impressive about their...
Yesterday, Illinois over Nebraska.
7, not bad. Bishop Ford, Lakeshore Drive, and the tollways, including the Tri-State Adams, Reagan, and Veterans Memorial, completely clear. What you want to watch for on the northwest side is Nagel's closed with an electric pole that's down between Montrose and Gunnison. And then on the west side, we've got an accident at Ashland, just south of Grand Avenue. Get traffic and weather together on the 8th. It's every 10 minutes on News Radio 780 and 105.9 FM WBBM.
WBBM, AccuWeather, plenty of sunshine today. A chilly day, a high of 33. Tonight, partly cloudy, a low of 20. Mostly cloudy tomorrow and a high of 35 with snow arriving in the evening. About 3 to 6 inches of snow tomorrow night, most of it south of Chicago. Right now, we have sunny skies and 20 in Joliet. Sunny skies and 19 at O'Hare. It's 21 at Midway and 28 along the lakefront. And a benefit being held today in Kenosha, Wisconsin.
One Earth Film Festival.
The One Earth Film Festival. To maintain your policy. Options for you to adjust your policy. When you get that letter, the insurance company says, here's your new premium. If you do nothing, you'll pay this your next go-round. Or, letter of saying,
shot with this group. I want to say to Spurs, but you know what? I'm going to say to Clippers.
The best physical.
Just
can our insurance specialist?
Misha Davidson.
Try the shortwave band.
And only in 8 years you could see that there has been a great decline in his mobility.
Yeah.
From the time that he took off, he could barely, you know, move his head now.
Yeah.
Got the antenna all raised up here.
I agree with his resignation, so anyway. Okay, let's move.
It's Sunday morning, so there's really not going to be a whole lot to choose from here.
Because you don't know, because you don't know what God's really saying or what he's doing, you got a misconception why Jesus Christ came into the world.
I was picking up WWV earlier, but it's not really coming in right now. Pretty sensitive shortwave receiver. In the evenings, right around 5 megahertz here, you could pick up all kinds of stuff. There's really nothing now.
Yes, has come down onto you having great wrath.
But that's about it. Works quite well, so it's all set and ready to go for hopefully many more years of faithful operation. And this is the Panasonic R-805 restoration.